I can say I am cloud hired. My name is Richard Ferrer. I currently live in Peoria, Arizona, and I'm originally from New York City. And I can say I am cloud hired. The company that I work for is called Relayer, R-E-L-A-Y-R. So I am a solution architect dealing with the IoT technology sector of Relayer. And they specifically deal with IoT technologies using Azure, but they kind of go in different directions in terms of the IoT, the hardware, things of that. So, but my total compensation put me in the six-figure range, which was another like goal I had in mind with this journey, was that I couldn't settle for less than six figures because of all the work I put in and the sacrifices that my family had to deal with as well. So me personally, how I can explain it without getting, too deep on what the IRS auditing me. With those two jobs that I had working, the compensation at Relayer actually has me making more than both of my jobs combined by almost, I'll say 2,000, give or take. No, yes. And what I wanted people to learn from like my personal experience with this is I actually was working two jobs. I don't want to say simultaneously, but like it was pretty much one after another, just how the schedules broke down. So it kind of just flowed into one big shift, so to speak. So one was at a bank, and I've been there for around 3 years, and it was like a dual role of like a business operations analyst slash technical architect, and then the other role was another financial company, third party, and that was more just like fraud detection, fraud analyst role, something that I've had a ton of experience in my previous years working in the financial sector. So I was literally working two jobs while in the postgraduate program to get the certification on top of doing the weekly assignments for Mike. So I committed to it full time as I was actually enrolled in this postgraduate program offered by the University of Texas, Austin. And then I believe I got up to week six in the program. And then that's when it was on average about a call a week in terms of recruiters reaching out to me via LinkedIn, like via Indeed, other job boards. And then from there, it was getting a little bit difficult to keep up with the program just because I was getting calls once a week that then led to phone screenings, interviews. So that's when it got kind of tough to keep up. But overall, I was committed to it full time. So I actually started off studying to be a data scientist and going in the AI ML field. And something came up about AWS and Azure. And then I kind of just went into this rabbit hole of searching salaries, searching like the actual job details, etc. And then I just woke up the next day like, you know what, I'm going to shift gears. I'm going to just focus everything on being a cloud architect, solution architect, and I'm just going to be married to the idea. Whether it takes me 10 years, 5 years, however long, I'm just going to stick with it. So I officially started that journey in September of 2020. I studied to get the AWS Solution Architect Associate Certification. I got that in December of 2020. And then tying into GoCloud, I was coming across YouTube videos just to see like what's the best thing to do for your resume, how to stand out, just certain things. And I saw a few of Mike's, Michael Gibbs' videos on YouTube. started seeing them, and then I found them on LinkedIn, and then just sharing messages with him. He actually private messaged me. He told me about his program, and the way he was explaining it, I thought it would be great, and I joined immediately. And that's how I pretty much found Mike, was through my personal journey of trying to become a cloud architect, literally finding a few videos on YouTube, and then it circled to LinkedIn. We had a few private messages, and then I ended up enrolling. So what I like about it and what really separates you guys is the presentation piece and just the overall of like being comfortable to speak to higher like C-level executives or just someone who has a ton of knowledge like Michael. But just some of the assignments of being on the webcam, looking at yourself, talking and not feeling self-conscious about it, and just focusing on getting the message across of understanding you're using a specific technology, AWS, Azure, GCP, Oracle Cloud, whatever the case is, and you're trying to solve a situation for a business. So you always want to keep that in mind. You know, you don't want to get too far left with the tech where you're just kind of throwing technical jargon at whoever you're meeting with. It's to solve the business situation first, figure that out, and then figure out how you can build a solution around that using tech. And I think that's what separates you guys the most from the programs, because a lot of programs I've looked at and compared to, they're so tech heavy, which is great because you need to understand the tech, but the interpersonal relationship skills and the soft skills, I see those kind of lacking because they're not really trained on it. So I'm giving you all this tech information, but at the end of the day, how does that still solve our problem as a business? So that's where you guys separate yourselves, and that's what I would stress to anyone looking to enroll, is that's what's going to put you ahead with your so-and-so competitors. It prepared me tremendously. The interview process at Relay was actually refreshing because it wasn't so many where you kind of got bogged down. It was a video screening with their HR person, and she quickly passed me along, which was great. And then my official interview with, I guess he's my hiring manager, and I guess a colleague of mine that I'm working with, but they're based in Germany. I actually had to do a presentation style interview, and we used the app Miro. So I had to conduct a diagram architect based off of Azure of a IoT device that was placed in, I think it was a pizzeria oven. It was just like a make-believe problem, and I had to architect using Azure how we'd get the IoT device connected to Azure's IoT hub, and then going from there to which database we would use, and then which object storage we would use, then the business interface, streaming analytics. And I also think I placed some AI ML features into it, just kind of showing the depth. And then what I did after that is, because I'm more proficient in AWS and then Azure's like second, I redid it in AWS. So to tie up for Go Cloud, you guys are so heavy with the presentation styles that it actually prepared me tremendously, just because of you and Michael Gibbs doing that on the YouTube videos and some of the calls I was able to review. So it helped me out tremendously to be able to feel confident that, hey, I can do this presentation. And just the way how Michael explains executive presence, soft skills, that you know you don't have to rush into it, give yourself some breaks, some pauses, and just feeling confident with that. So once I saw that as an interview and how it was going to be, I felt like extremely confident. And that's how I knew like Go Cloud program really put me like head and shoulders, just because once I found that out, I knew I kind of had it. Yeah, no, it just allowed me to start thinking things in a different light, and how I approach speaking to people too. I kind of actually try to embed it in myself with practicing soft skills, just not when it comes to work or anything business related, but just at home, talking with people, using your pauses and your breaks, and just trying to incorporate that in your life. Because if you can incorporate that in your life, when it gets to the work setting, it's actually easier. And you're just substituting the normal conversation you'd have with a business conversation, a tech conversation. So I did take that with me. And then just also being able to listen. That's one thing I've tried to incorporate more with my life, is just to listen more. And, you know, you and Mike do a great job of focusing on that. You'd be surprised how many, you know, architects or just people in general who don't really listen. And that can actually separate you, whether it's personal or business. So it actually does impact your personal life more than people assume. And those are some of the takeaways I've gotten and used personally. I think the one thing that caught me off guard, that was like a great surprise, was how many people were eager to learn and how many people joined. Because I remember it trickled in when I first started, and I was doing the LinkedIn post at our private program. And you know, there would be a couple of people every week, and then at one point it just scaled. And then when you guys moved to Slack, like, that's when the calls were coming in, so it was tough to be able to keep up with the two jobs. And I had just finished the University of Texas program in October of 2021, so it was just a tough stretch. But and just the people that reached out to me on LinkedIn personally about GoCloud, and like, they've started, how excited they were. And I would tell them along the way, like, it's going to be tough, especially if you're not in the tech sector, or if you have a fear of like public speaking or whatever. You have to get out of your comfort zone, and you have to just kind of stick with it. But, you know, Mike and Chris will help. And, you know, depending on your situation, you will see the results. So that was like the surprise for me, is how quickly it grew. And then just seeing, you know, the YouTube videos and how many views were coming about, how many subscribers, which was a great and pleasant surprise. And I just love how it's expanded to so many different people, so many different walks of life. Forgive me again, but there was a young gentleman that just received a AWS offer. And I think he's still in school. And you guys did a piece on him that was great. And I actually watched, I believe, an hour 15 of it, and just his journey. So I think the greatest thing about this is it allows people to be relatable towards each other. And everyone starts off in a different part of their life, family, maybe single, schooling, two jobs. But it just shows that, you know, tech can encompass, and there's a place for everyone, as long as you're able to put in the work and just kind of stick it out. But these programs have helped people show that you can start anywhere and reach your goal. Trust me, with this program, you'll be able to overcome a lot of hurdles and just stick with it. And you, whatever destination you're looking for, you will get it.